Let's welcome up our last team. They're gonna do it real big, 2012. Blue Dream! With Zoe Wigger, Emily Nevin, Richard Alberto, and Jessica Fernando.
My skin and makes sweat drip into my eyes. I am the atlas of the sun, but I want to be flung into the unknown, the dark and dreadful wild of my subconscious. I will await my chariot, lavishly laced with the trimmest of trappings, simply oozing respect and refinement. My chariot will glide across the sands and gently lull the world into a hue of dark blues, and purples will pour from my fingers upon all that I touch. This eternal desert houses my cruel feast, and I simply can't wait to sink my teeth into their skulls and let their thoughts draw them onto my own. We will become a united kingdom. Already I can see myself immersed in this graceful reality, forever a silver goddess to my minions. They will frolic at my feet and dance around like children, joyful, with denial hiding just behind their eyes. All around my hands, they will crawl and roll and jest, all the while running needles into my chest, trying to best me in their foolish games. They think they can have me. They think I will bend to them. I am under no control. I will sit on my throne and bellow over my crowd like the majestic creature I am. I am on your side, silly beasts. I am your queen, and I will stay here and never leave any of you. My blood will run across the walls and stain the bricks red so they remember it was I who allowed them to live. All about my hips, they thoughtlessly trip and skip to the shuddering of my skin. They callously cauterize. It's as if they've forgotten I was the one who cut ties from my sails to sew them closed. My hair flips and lifts from my head while this smoke dream courses through a dreaming of being seen like it may soon be said that they were my true creators. Well, I was the goddess. I was the only one who was ever really ready to take a stand for them. But as they drag me to the guillotine, I realize that my delirious season has withered and I've lost all of their trust. They see me as nothing but flesh to be thrown to the dogs. The blade glints off my eyes, brilliantly the silver like I once shone, but they've shown me I don't belong anywhere. There is a sudden chill. My body becomes cold and shapeless and pointless. And I lay here alone and ashamed as the heat leaves my mind and buries itself in the sands of my ever-flowing desert.
Judges' score on that are 9, 8.5, 9, 9.5, 9, and 10.
Cigarette smoke curls off dirty hands as I wave bye to Miss American Pie. And Don McLean sings of the day the music died, but I find it very much alive within my soul, paralleling the beats of my heart onto my eardrums. The Beatles told me of a yellow submarine that could take me across the universe to a sea of golden slumbers and love and life. And who was the seeker of dreams that drove me on that magic bus to a place where the familiar sound of crackling of the record player lulled my generation to sleep? And who are the people manipulating motions with guitar strings and drumsticks creating music even bigger than Pete Townsend's nose? When Horace Faith helped me help myself, my fingers grasped a pen for dear life to scribble lines of poetry of crying lovers and bad decisions. Lovers like Ike and Tina singing Oop Hoop Hadoo, even though once they sauntered off stage, she crawled away bruised and abused. I want to tell her, want to scream at all the sad little kids inside of us, run like the runaways, forget those wasted school days, and cherry bomb your way to Hollywood with your black leather, away from dead-end justice. Run to where the music can live inside you, bury itself in your lungs and allow you to breathe the lyrical loveliness of song, allow you to belong to the liveliness of fast beats and low bass. When the sun goes down and the music gets loud, I dance with Arctic monkeys. And when those good British boys drown themselves in liquor and paint the town with dark red wine, they whisper fake tales of San Francisco into my ear, a certain romance I just can't seem to consume fast enough. Like Sham 69, the kids are united by these variations of notes and beats. They surge through our bloodstream like the words of Jack Kerouac, that the only people for me are the mad ones. Well, hell, we kids are the mad ones. Mad with love, mad with hate, mad with sorrow that falls into fate. We are mad with life, and we follow that madness to the musicians that got banned from the Roxy. That craftswoman sick with penis envy wrote songs to mend the hearts of the young punk chicks that were broken by society. There's always been that minor threat of bottled violence that leaves angry kids screaming at a wall from the accumulations of lyrical and instrumental innovations. Sometimes the music lets me think, and sometimes it makes me drink, and sometimes it allows me to dance, and sometimes it causes me to weep. But at the end of the day, when the music doesn't play, there's nothing left to do but sleep. So I'm still with those good old boys drinking whiskey and rye, just praying that the music will never die. Because if that day comes, then so will I.
Judges' scores are 9, 9.5, 9, 9, 10, and 10.
Verses, superfluous adjectives, and I warp wimpy words without worth in a wild way, just to make alliteration that has no definition. With end rhymes to lean on, leading into internal rhymes to internalize, I forget the purpose of writing, fighting the will to stop, take a breath, and remember. I once had verses on verses of words, spinning a tapestry, glorifying the self-proclaimed poets of the Dead Poet Society. Running amok the manicured lawns, crawled away in caves where the long-forgotten words poured from their mouths and went finger-painting across the cavern walls. Lessons of the carefree reality that Carpe Diem once preached before it became an inked-out, overused tattoo, our freedom of speech. A ruse of the tortured mind, abused by the lameness and boring life where I can't find the time to just take a drive. And the price of originality has risen with the recession. And my inspiration, my muse, has hit an all-time low depression. Seceding from minutes, ticking as a new sunray shining, hitting my alarm clock on snooze. Even though I've been up all night calling for my muse. Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou Romeo? Oh wait, I'm sorry, was that line already taken? The piracy of words, downloading verses quicker than albums, copy, paste, turn in. Turn yourselves in for your archaic thoughts, the obsolete phrases, cliched from day to day. But who am I to judge? I'm not a poet.
Judges' scores are 8.5, 8, 8.5, 9, 9, and 9. Give it up for Blue Dream.